Hey, how's it going? Welcome to Rapid Fire Reaper Tutorials. All the info, none of the fluff, so let's get to it. Been a really long time. Did you miss me? Today, we're going to talk about how to record yourself. So somebody on Reddit asked this question. How do you do takes in Reaper? I'm not sure if take is the right terminology. If I want to record a guitar solo, for example, can I set up the recording so that I can just improvise a solo 5 or 6 times with it automatically looping back with a counting to the beginning between takes? Currently, what I'm doing is manually stuffing the recording, setting up a new track, and then recording another one. It's slow and tedious. What I'd like is to just keep going without interruption until I play something that sounds good, then listen back to the takes and pick the best one. Cool, great question. This is definitely a pretty common problem with a lot of people because they record themselves, right? So you have to kind of be the engineer and the musician at the same time. COVID aside, I've been doing it like this for a really long time. So I've kind of developed a system. So I want to show you my system. I have a very simple drum loop. I have some markers and this is my recording track. What you want to do is to, for example, set a loop and start recording. So while Reaper automatically allows this, I'm going to show you some new tricks. So usually when I press record, I don't have enough time to kind of get my mind into the performance. So I have this command in my main toolbar called pre-roll toggle pre-roll on record. So if I turn it on, when I press record, it starts from 2 measures before and then starts recording. So you can always right click on your metronome and then here you can set your pre-roll setting. So for example, I have it set to 2 measures. So that's good. That gives me 2 measure of time to get my stuff together after I press record. That's still not really good for me. You know, I have the default command transport record to R, but I also have another command that I set to numpad 3. Pro Tools people will get it. This is a very simple custom action that I prefer to use when I record myself. All it does is that it waits 3 seconds before it records. So now I'm getting ready to record and I'm going to press 3 and I'm going to get up and start doing takes. So when I press 3, the unfortunate thing is that it shows you the wheel of doom, but don't worry about it. So I press record and now I have 3 seconds to get up and grab my pick and get in the right mental space. Then I start hearing the metronome for 2 measures and then I start playing. I like this approach because when I press record, even with the pre-roll on, I'm hearing a metronome and it already gives me anxiety and kind of rushes me along, and I don't want that. So I prefer this method. When I get to the end of the time selection, we will loop back to the beginning of it, and it looks like we're overwriting the file, but don't worry, we're not. We're simply recording the audio on a secondary take. We can keep looping and keep recording over those measures without losing those recordings. So I just did a bunch of takes, and now as you can see, they're all on top of each other, right? So it shows that I have done 6 takes. This last take is throwaway, right? Right click on take and go delete active take. So that's nice. So now we got 5 takes and I can simply click on them to toggle between them. So if I want, I can shift double click this track and then play. I can use K to toggle between them. A few things to note, if I drag this out, this is all one file. So all the takes are just recorded onto one audio file, but there is a setting for it. Preferences, audio loop recording. You can set it to create new files on loop. Let's just quickly show you what that looks like. So right now this is just one file and it's all these takes, but now with that option turned on, I'm going to record a few more takes. So now this time it recorded new files. So I can see their names up here. So when I press K, I see the new one. So I got 23, 24, 24, 1, 24, 2. And if I go to my finder, 23, 24, 24, 1, 24, 2. So have that preference on if you want it. I like to keep that option off and record just one audio file because A, like Reaper's non-destructive anyway, but B, sometimes this happens. So I started my 4th take a little early. So a little bit of the audio file was recorded over here. So let's say I was going with take 4. I'm missing a bit of the transient, but I can always just drag it back and there it is. Now before I show you comping, I want to show you one more thing. Right now we got takes because we recorded a loop. It just looped an 8 section bar. When you're improvising, sometimes you don't exactly know how many bars you want to improvise, right? So I want to just start improvising from here and I don't know when I'll stop. So what I can do, I showed you what my number 3 does. So it's gonna wait. So this time, because I didn't set a time selection, I have to manually stop myself. But what I don't want to do is press stop and then go back to where I started and record again. That takes too long, especially from a standing position. So let's say I did this take and I'm happy with it. Let's say I want to do another take. So from a standing position, if I press 2, it stops the recording and goes back to the pre-roll. So this is a custom action that basically waits 1 second before next action and then stops the recording. Then it waits an additional second before pressing record again. By waiting 1 second, I preserve the tail in my last recording that I'm stopping. And then that one extra second again gets me time to get into recording mode. And then I do another take. It always starts from the same place anyway. And then let's say, oh, this time I screwed something up. So I have another hotkey, which is option, command, and spacebar. And if I press it, it'll delete that last section. So that last recording I did, this just deleted it. This is an action called transport stop delete all recorded media. It deletes the file and gets me back to my starting point. Be aware that this deletes the actual audio file from your drive. So it helps with decluttering, but you know, you need to be aware that that file is gone forever. There's no command in Z-ing out of this one. And then I press stop and I'm back in business. So I can delete the tail if I want to. I can even dial it back to this amount. You know, I can always make more cuts and then I can select some stuff. Maybe this is how I like it. And then I can choose all of them. I can right click, go to take, lock to active take. And now I can't choose another take. Normally, if I click on any take, I can choose it. Another thing you can do again from the same window is to go duplicate active take. And when I do that, all the takes that I selected go down here. And then my lanes remain kind of normal the way they were, with each take just going continuously, which is a little easier if you want. So that was a little bit on how to make recording yourself a little easier and a little less annoying and a little bit on comping. But I'm going to continue the rest of this video tomorrow because there are some aspects of comping in Reaper that I'm not a huge fan of, so I kind of created my own system. So I'm going to show you all of that tomorrow. And yeah, I hope this was helpful, and the rest of it comes tomorrow. So stay tuned. Bye.